Hello, and welcome back to Ultimate Admiral Dreadnoughts. Lots of convoy battles this turn. Let's start with this one. Oldenburg and Sachsen versus Kita and two light cruisers. So I'm thinking the Sachsen will get to deal with the light cruisers while Oldenburg tries to kill the battlecruiser. The enemy is spotted because these ships have been refit with radar. The transports have been spotted too. So the Sachsen will actually start firing on those. Yeah, that must be the battlecruiser. It is being targeted. Let's just have the Sachsen focus on the transports for now. And that's a light cruiser. So it will have priority. Transports can wait till we've killed the escorts. Actually, Sachsen can also take on the battlecruiser. There we go. Yeah, it doesn't have the heaviest armor, so even the 12-inch guns on the Sachsen can do some damage. I think we're gonna flood it. I think we're just gonna sink the battlecruiser first and then take on the light cruisers and then the transports. Sachsen doesn't have the best angle. There we go. Kita sank. They've launched torpedoes. Let's just not be where those torpedoes are gonna be. This one I think is gonna launch soon. No, it's not, because its torpedoes blew up. Kinpu still has 4 torpedoes. So it is now the priority target for the main guns. Kinpu sank. Just the Unebi left. We can start speeding up going for the transports. Because Unebi is really no threat anymore without torpedoes. And I know we sank one transport, maybe two. Saxon is a little bit faster, so she can just speed up. Yeah, these are the damaged ones. And there's another group of transports even further ahead. So once that one is sunk, we can probably go back up to times 30 game speed. Catch the last ones. You can see the radar pings up there. Not the biggest transports. Target one each. I don't know. Maybe some of this can be used as a thumbnail. think. There we go. One battlecruiser and two lights sunk with very minimal damage taken. That's what I like to see. And that's also one thing I like about battlecruisers, even when they're kind of obsolete like this, they can still be very useful. Because they are fast enough to do those kind of convoy hunting missions. Yeah, this is not going anywhere. 17%, yeah, we checked that at the end of the last episode. Strike! We got... No, these are... Comet! That's a new ship. Another Tsukushi class battlecruiser and some of the Mogami class light cruisers. Alright. And the latest Repair 3 patch notes said that they'd fixed something with the UI. But those pop-up messages, when you hover over something, they still go kind of off the screen. Don't really need my DDs as screening ships. Because I'm already spotting everything with my radar. Yeah, top speed of the Mecklenburg is cruise speed of the Comet. So they can, I guess, just go at the same speed. Okay, yeah, they're smoking up, that's why I lost vision on light cruisers. That's okay. I'm spotting them even through smoke. Torpedoes away. Get the yachty, please. Some more torpedoes in the water. See which side is reloaded. That side, perfect. Out of torpedoes. Out of torpedoes. Chito still has torpedoes. No, she does not. There they are. Let's maybe try to get my DDs. Get some torpedoes launched on the yachty. Kerfurst is all out of AP. That's very bad. Are almost out of AP also. Just have my DDs shower the light cruiser with 5-inch fire while closing in on the battle cruiser. There we go. Got her in the turn. Not quite as many torpedo hits as I'd hoped for, but it is something. Now, which side is... okay, I guess it's either side. Torpedo's not quite ready yet. But almost. Might not need the torpedoes. Nope, did not need more torpedoes. Alright, another 7,000 victory points. And I think there were two more convoy battles. At least one of them against the British. I think they had a pretty big convoy. Let's do this one first. Two of the Eitel Friedrich and the Komoran. And 7 transports. So we should have an advantage here. That could be a thumbnail. Unless I choose to use the one with the transports from before. 42 kilometers, okay. Are they running? Nope. They're closing in. Eitel Friedrich is a little bit low on ammo. Might just actually turn your guns off till they get closer. Actually, let's turn both your guns off. Conserve ammunition. And I know I have a 30-kilometer range on these guns, but I don't really think they're gonna do much at that kind of range. But at 12, yes. Aren't actually scoring a flooding hit. Gonna send the Cormoran up here to start taking down the transports. My battlecruisers are kind of low on AP shells. Hopefully it will be enough. At least accuracy is pretty good. Transports are being sunk. these Japanese battlecruisers are just not that great. They're not super terrible, but if I didn't have radar, they would have a pretty good advantage in tower spotting, I think. Because they've got those pagoda towers. But now I soon have an advantage in having AP shells, which the Eitel Friedrich no longer has. And the Lauenburg is soon also without. Might manage a couple of salvos into extensive fire, never mind. I didn't need AP shells. These are practically unarmed. And is that the last one? I think so. Now that might take Japan out of the war, hopefully. Now, I would like to, if possible, take the rest of the Korean Peninsula, but I think that we'll have to wait for another war. Come on, let me... There we go. They're advancing 7% to Northeast Korea, 9% into Manchuria. I don't know why they all went to Wei Hai Wei instead of Haichao. This naval invasion, I think, is going according to plan. Construction capacity, a little bit over limit. But none of my ships are seriously damaged. It's all just scratched paint. They're down to 19%. I'm still at 100. So is Japan. and the Soviet Union. Yeah. Two heavy cruisers, settler class. And a light cruiser and 14 transports, alright. And it's the good old nice now. One of the originals, I think. But, you know, 11-inch guns, they're... they don't go out of fashion. At least not yet. I just got coincidence 4. So main disadvantage of this cruiser class, other than not being like super fast, is the terrible spotting range. But as long as we have these Frankfurt class light cruisers here, that's not really a problem. Because we're outspotting them by a lot. I don't have a lot of torpedoes though. Big 11-inch guns on the Neisenau, already opening up. And these must be the heavy cruisers. Pretty sure. Yeah. Let's try and weaken them with torpedoes first. Actually, torpedoes off. Let's get a better firing angle. torpedo detonation aboard the Cressy. A torpedo hit on the Edinburgh. There we go. My torpedoes are spent. I don't think they're gonna hit, and it may be some transports. Duke of Edinburgh is gonna sink. AP. Nice now. AP. We can get a little bit more flooding on the Duke. And I don't know, maybe burn down the Cressy? Close. Yeah, Duke of Edinburgh is gonna sink. Finish off the Cressy. Wasn't that this side that had loaded the torpedoes? Yeah. Come on, do you need a special invitation to launch? Okay. Never mind then. Guns are slapping the light cruiser, as are the 6-inch guns. More, and then we go and kill the transports. That's it. They do not have torpedoes. Just gonna send the Nysa now up alongside them. Could have brought in the DDs for this too, but yeah, they're low on ammo, no torpedoes. Guess they could have used AP shells to sink the transports. Almost no damage taken in that entire brawl. But keep in mind, all British ships are now crewed by cadets, because they can't afford crew training. And this is where I would like to just have the times 10 game speed available, even if the enemy is within 25 kilometers. Because it really is just like a slaughter at this point. Let's just watch them. It's like a little cinematic. I guess it would be more cinematic at like real game speed. It's so cool you can see the guns elevate as they're loaded and ready to fire. It's kind of low in the water, I guess. -1% draft. Could use torpedoes now, but I might need them in the next battle, which will probably be next turn. And apparently there's a limit on how much ammo and torpedoes and stuff you get resupplied each turn. So if your ships get into combat every turn, they're probably never gonna be fully stocked up on ammunition. Unless you expend very little. So yeah, I think that's actually the end of the episode. Quite a few smaller battles. I think we're gonna get some big ones tomorrow. It's 4 battleships, 1 battlecruiser. And that task force. Another 4 battleships there. Britain has 40-something battleships in total. Let's take a look at fleet sizes. Before we go. United States, 216 ships. 9 battleships and 1 battlecruiser. Austria-Hungary, with a surprisingly strong economy. You typically don't see Austria-Hungary doing this well, this late into a campaign. But being a long-time ally of the player tends to have its perks. Yeah, no battleships or battlecruisers, but they are very limited in port capacity, so that might not be a bad thing. And at least some of these heavy cruisers are my designs, and they're quite solid. France, 112 ships. Also, surprisingly strong economy. Second best after United States. 3 battleships, 10 battlecruisers. Italy, also doing well economically. Only 60 ships. That's why they're just Yeah, stacking money. Japan. Kind of in a recess. They were doing very well. One of the nations with an advanced technology level. Now only average. 119 ships, of which 50 are submarines. Spain, 139 ships, of which 88 are submarines, but 47 battlecruisers. Also surprisingly strong. Economically, not very good in terms of technology. Same with China. A lot of submarines. Soviet Union, decent navy, decent economy. Britain, massive amounts of battleships and battlecruisers that they cannot afford to crew or supply. And also they're somehow at war with seemingly everyone. Oh well. I'm still not suffering from transport losses. Still at over 100% transport capacity. Anything I need to suspend? Nah, everything is coming in more or less on time. Like the minute repairs start going over 1 month, you need to start suspending construction to bring it down, because you just want them out of your port, out of your shipyards, as soon as possible. So we're going to have two more cruisers finished next turn, which is nice. What are we getting? Cruiser design. Yeah, still working on advanced battlecruiser. 18-inch guns, Mark 1s, useless. But we're also getting modern battleships. I'm not going to bother prioritizing it, because it's going to be more than 3 months until we have the construction capacity to actually build them. Torpedo contact exploder. I am prioritizing big guns despite not needing the 18-inch, because once those are done, I'm gonna start improving the guns I do use. But that's it for this episode. Goodbye and take care.